Now we will discuss about nitrogen dioxide. The chemical formula of nitrogen dioxide is NO2. It is a poisonous gas. When fossil fuels such as petrol, diesel, coal and natural gases are burned, they release nitric oxide gas in the air. Nitric oxide reacts with oxygen to convert into nitrogen dioxide. The presence of nitrogen dioxide gas in the air is harmful to the human body. Nitrogen dioxide gas reacts with volatile organic compounds in the presence of sunlight to form a chemical that is called peroxyacetyl nitrate, which causes photochemical smog. Peroxyacetyl nitrate causes irritation in the eyes and lungs and makes breathing difficult. Note that transportation is a major source of nitrogen dioxide in the air, leading to global warming in the world. These are some important information about nitrogen dioxide. Now let's discuss about its preparation reaction. The first preparation reaction is by heating metal nitrates. On heating metal nitrates, we get corresponding metal oxide, nitrogen dioxide and oxygen gas. We have metal nitrate, we get metal oxide gas and so we get oxygen gas also. Okay, metal can be, M is standing for metal, it can be lead, it can be copper, it can be calcium, it can be barium also. Let's say I take lead nitrate. On heating lead nitrate, we get lead oxide, two molecules of nitrogen dioxide, and we get oxygen gas also. Okay, if I take, you know, copper nitrate, in this case we'll get copper oxide, we can say cupric oxide also, two molecules of nitrogen dioxide, and we get oxygen gas also. Okay, if I take a calcium nitrate, very simple reaction is there. On heating, it decomposes to produce calcium oxide, two molecules of nitrogen dioxide, and so we get oxygen gas also. Very simple reaction is there, easily we can complete it. It's a kind of decomposition reaction. Okay, on heating, metal nitrates decomposes into corresponding metal oxide, releasing nitrogen dioxide gas and oxygen gas. Now let's move on to the second preparation reaction. The second preparation reaction is by the reaction of metals with concentrated solution of nitric acid. Metals can be copper, silver, and it can be lead also. In the previous lectures, as we have seen, as we change the concentration of nitric acid in a chemical reaction, different products are found. Keep in mind, in this chemical reaction we are going to use highly concentrated solution of nitric acid, and when we use highly concentrated solution of nitric acid, it releases nitrogen dioxide by releasing nascent oxygen, because it is a strong oxidizing agent. We can balance this equation is balanced. 4 + 1 + 1 = 6 oxygen. This equation is balanced. In this case, we have to use this base equation. Let's say copper is being oxidized by nascent oxygen released by nitric acid. The presence of a strong acid is there. I can take two molecules of nitric acid, because copper will react with acid to form salt. We have copper nitrate. Okay. Now in this case, what will happen? Two hydrogen will combine with nascent oxygen to form water molecule. Second equation is also balanced. Okay. Now we can add both equation. We cancel nascent oxygen. We have 2 to 4 molecules of nitric acid. Copper is there, other side we get 2 molecules of nitrogen dioxide. Copper nitrate is there, 2 water molecules are there, 2 molecules of water are there, 2H2O. Okay, equation is balanced. Okay, so you can see copper is being oxidized by nitric acid, releasing nitrogen dioxide. Let's see if I take silvers. Okay, I take silvers. So in this case, you can see we have silvers. Let me complete this reaction. This is nascent oxygen. So silver is being oxidized by nascent oxygen. I take acid, strong acid, HNO3. The presence of acid will be there in the chemical reaction. Silver ion has positive charge, nitrate ion has negative charge. Combined together, we get salt silver nitrate. Okay, silver nitrate. Now pay attention very carefully. We have one hydrogen and we have one oxygen, HO. No, we take two molecules of nitric acid so that we can get two hydrogen will combine with nascent oxygen, we get water molecule. Okay, now we can balance nitrate ion multiplied by 2, balance silvers, then we have 2. Okay, equation is balanced. Now we can add nascent oxygen will cancel out 2, 2, 4 molecules of nitric acid we get. 2 molecules of silver is there and we get 2 molecules of nitrogen dioxide and we have 2 molecules of AgNO3 is there and 2 molecules of water is there. Okay, in this case you can divide this entire equation by 2, so it will be 2 cancel and cancel. Okay, final equation will be 2HNO3 plus silver and then we get NO2, then we get AgNO3 and then we get water molecule. This is the final equation. Okay, so very interesting concept is there. Easily you can complete the reaction in a similar manner. You can take lead also. Lead nitrate will be formed releasing nitrogen dioxide gas. Okay, now let's discuss about its properties. Next we have properties of nitrogen dioxide. Chemical formula is NO2. If you calculate the total number of outermost shell electrons, nitrogen has 5 electrons in the outermost shell. There are 2 oxygen, each oxygen has 6 outermost shell electrons. We can calculate it's 12 plus 5 is equal to 17 electrons. Since you can see this molecule has odd number of electrons, that's why it is paramagnetic by nature. Now we talk about its structure. Okay, as we have seen, nitrogen can form only 3 bond because it does not have the vacant orbital. Okay, so nitrogen is there, there are 2 oxygen, one bond is there forming one bond. Okay, the valency of nitrogen is satisfied, it has one lone pair. Now pay attention very carefully. Okay, this nitrogen is having 2 lone pairs. Nitrogen can form maximum how many bond? 2 bond, and if it is forming less than 2 bond, it will always carry one negative charge. Okay, you can see here we have resonance can also be there. You can see double bond, single bond, negative charge is there. That's why it can show resonating structures. Lone pair is there, double bond you can put over here, and then oxygen having negative charge. Okay, this is also one resonating structure is there. Okay, this electron density will go this side creating double bond, and this electron density will pulled by this oxygen, so it will be a negative charge. Negative charge is over here. Okay, now let's say if you want to show coordinate bond, nitrogen is having a double bond with oxygen, oxygen is there, and now it is donating its lone pairs to oxygen, lone pair to oxygen. Pay attention very carefully. You can see 2 electrons used by nitrogen this side, and it has also used 2 electrons to other oxygen, then it is left with only 1 electron. This is a dot acting as a free radical. Okay, since it is donating electron pair having positive charge, since it is gaining electron density, that's why it is having negative charge. Okay, as you can, it is a part of resonance because it is double bond, single bond, and so negative charge. So you can say, so the resonating structure, nitrogen, it will carry positive charge only. And in this case, we have oxygen, negative charge, and double bond will come this side. So these are the resonating structure of nitrogen dioxide. Okay, in this case we have created only covalent bond, and in this case we created covalent bond as well as coordinate bond. Okay, resonating structure in this case also, and here also we have resonating structure. Well, the nitrogen oxygen bond length we have 119 picometers, and the bond angle which we are getting, that is 132 degree bond angle is there. Okay, so remember this data. Now let's move on to some more information. As we have seen, nitrogen dioxide has 17 electrons in its outermost shell. It has odd number of electrons, that's why it is in unstable state. This is the reason nitrogen dioxide undergoes dimerization to produce dinitrogen tetraoxide. NO2 has 17 electrons, in this case 2 multiplied by 5 plus 4 multiplied by 6, 10 and 6 4 is 24, total we have 34 electrons. Okay, even number of electrons is there. Odd number of electrons, that's why it is paramagnetic by nature. Even number of electrons, that's why it is diamagnetic by nature. Paramagnetic means colorful, and so diamagnetic means it is colorless. It is less stable, it is more stable, because all the electrons are in the paired position. Okay, now if you talk about the structure of dinitrogen tetroxide, tetraoxide, then in this case we can say nitrogen nitrogen linkage is there. Oxygen double bond oxygen, okay, coordinate bond oxygen, double bond oxygen. Now pay attention very carefully. Nitrogen forming more than three bond will always carry positive charge. Positive charge. Oxygen forming less than two bond will always carry negative charge. Okay, negative charge is there. Lone pairs. These two oxygen will carry two lone pairs. Their valency is satisfied. This has planar structure. These all the atoms are in the same plane. Like this is a plane, and these all the atoms are present in the same plane. No above the plane, no below the plane. Okay. Now, if you look at here, you know, nitrogen dioxide and dinitrogen tetroxide. Tetroxide, they have a good number of oxygen, that's why they act as a better oxidizing agent. They act as a better oxidizing agent. Now, let's discuss about the chemical reactions. Next, we have the chemical reaction of nitrogen dioxide. NO2 acts as a better oxidizing agent because it releases nascent oxygen. Nitric oxide and nascent oxygen. This is the base equation you have to use when it acts as a better oxidizing agent in the chemical reaction. Okay, NO2 has odd number of electrons, that's why it is colorful. What kind of color it has? Brown color, guys. It is a brown color gas. N2O4 does not have any colors. Okay, it is a brown color gas. It is a poisonous gas. Okay, NO2 oxidizes. Okay, sulfur into sulfur dioxide, phosphorus into P2O5, and carbon into carbon dioxide. Okay, easily you can complete the reaction. Use the base equation. We have NO2 converts into nitric oxide and nascent oxygen. This nascent oxygen oxidizes sulfurs and converts into SO2. Balance nascent oxygen. Okay, oxygen is balanced. Multiply this equation by 2, then it will be 2 is there, 2 is there, cancel out. Okay, I remove this 2, then we get 2 molecules of NO2 sulfur, and then 2 NO, and then SO2 is there. Reaction is complete. Okay, reaction is complete. Now let's say if I talk about phosphorus, NO2 is there, use the base equation, nitric oxide, and then we have nascent oxygen. Phosphorus is being oxidized by nascent oxygen to convert into in its highest oxidation state, that is +5. Okay, balance it to phosphorus, 5 oxygen, 5 nascent oxygen, multiply this equation by 5. Okay, then we get 5, 5 and 5. Okay, remove this number, cancel out, then we get 2 NO2, 2 phosphorus, 5 NO, and then we get P2O5. Reaction is complete. Okay, in a similar manner you can complete the reaction of carbon, in which carbon is getting oxidized into carbon dioxide. Let me take some more chemical reactions. Nitrogen dioxide oxidizes sulfur dioxide into sulfuric acid. It oxidizes hydrogen sulfide into sulfur. It oxidizes carbon monoxide into carbon dioxide. Okay, let's complete the reaction. We have NO2, use the base equation, nitric oxide and nascent oxygen. This nascent oxygen oxidizes sulfur dioxide into sulfuric acid. Okay, we have hydrogen. To get hydrogen, use water molecule. Water molecule is there. Okay, now pay attention here. Hydrogen is balanced, sulfur is also balanced. How many oxygen we have? 4 oxygen. This side also we have 4 oxygen. Equation is balanced. That's it. You can cancel nascent oxygen. We get, we have NO2, sulfur dioxide, H2O, and then we get nitric oxide and H2SO4. Reaction is complete. Okay. Now I take hydrogen sulfide. You can complete this reaction. This is easy reaction. We have NO2. Nitric oxide and nascent oxygen. Then we get H2S. We get nascent oxygen, and it is being oxidized into sulfurs. H2 will combine with O, giving water molecule. Nascent oxygen will cancel out. We get nitrogen dioxide, H2S, sulfurs, NO, and then we get H2O. Okay, that is how we can complete the reaction. Reaction is complete. Now let me take some more chemical reactions. Nitrogen dioxide oxidizes ferrous sulfate into ferric sulfate. फेरिक सल्फेट इट आल्सो ऑक्सीडाइजेस पोटेशियम आयोडाइड इनटू आयोडीन मॉलिक्यूल. लेट्स कंप्लीट द रिएक्शन. NO2 we have nitric oxide and then nascent oxygen. Okay, keep in mind this reaction will be taking place in the presence of a strong acid H2SO4 because it has sulfate ion. We have FeSO4 is oxidized by nascent oxygen into Fe2SO4 whole thrice is there. Okay, now we use a strong acid H2SO4. Sulfate ion you can balance. We have iron atoms, you can balance 2 and multiplied by 2. How many total sulfate ions are there? 3, 2 sulfate ion, 1 sulfate ion. You can see sulfate ion are balanced. 2 hydrogen combining with nascent oxygen making water molecule. Okay. Now we can cancel nascent oxygen. We have H2SO4, then 2 ferrous sulfate, then we have NO2. We get nitric oxide and ferric sulfate. All thrice and then we get H2O. Reaction is complete. Okay. Now next reaction is potassium iodide. You can complete this reaction directly. Ki is there. Okay, it is reacting with nitrogen dioxide, converts into iodine molecule, and we get potassium nitrite. Okay, balance this equation. Multiplied by 2. Is this equation balanced? Okay, is this equation balanced? Equation is balanced. Because iodine is what? -1, in this case it is 0. Oxidation is taking place. Okay. And in this case, this nitrogen is present in +4 oxidation state, +4 oxidation state, and in this case 2 to 4, it is present in +3 oxidation state. Okay. So this is also a complete redox reaction. Since you can see nitrogen is present in its intermediate oxidation state, that's why it can act as oxidizing agent and it can act as reducing agent also. Till now we have completed the reaction related to oxidizing property. Now let's discuss about some chemical reactions related to its reducing property. Next we have nitrogen dioxide acting as reducing agent. Okay. When nitrogen dioxide acting as a reducing agent, it accept nascent oxygen, converts into 2 molecules of nitric acid. This is the base equation you have to use. Balance this equation, put 2 molecules. Okay. Nitrogen dioxide reduces magnet ion into Mn2+. Okay, let's complete the reaction. This reaction takes place in the acidic medium, that's why I use H2SO4, converts into MnSO4, okay, and I have to use nascent oxygen this side. Now pay attention very carefully. Okay, potassium will combine with sulfate ion to form potassium sulfate K2SO4. How many sulfate ion are there? We have first of all we balance potassium. Okay, then you balance we have manganese. Okay, then how many sulfate ion are there? 2 + 1 = 3. You can take 3 molecules of sulfuric acid. Sulfate ion are present, balanced. Potassium is also balanced. Magnesium is also balanced. How many hydrogen are there? 3 hydrogen. I take 3 water molecule. Hydrogen is balanced. Okay. You can see how many oxygen we have. 8 oxygen. 3 oxygen we have used already. So that's why you can multiply by 5. Now oxygen is balanced. Because 5 oxygen plus 3 oxygen is equal to 8 oxygen. Okay, hydrogen and everything is balanced. Now in this equation we have only 1 nascent oxygen multiplied by 5. Then we get 5, then 5 to 10, 5, 5 to 10, and remove these numbers. Okay, now you can add. Okay, 5 water molecule, 3 water molecule, then we are left with 2 water molecule. Anything else? Okay, move on. We have 2 water molecule, 3H2SO4 and 2KMNO4, and then we have 2 molecules of NO2. Reaction is quite lengthy, so I make arrow from here. Then 10 molecules of nitric acid, then 2MNSO4 plus nascent oxygen we have cancelled out, K2SO4. This is the chemical reaction. Quite lengthy chemical reaction is there, but how conveniently we are able to complete this reaction. Let's move on to the next chemical reaction. Next we have NO2 is oxidized by, because it is acting as a reducing agent, is oxidized by ozone into N2O5 dinitrogen pentoxide. Okay, and ozone converts into oxygen gas. You can take two molecules, you know, so 4 oxygen, 7 oxygen, 5 to just 5 plus 2 is equal to 7 oxygen. Equation is balanced. Okay, now keep in mind we have N2O4. Now I focus on N2O4. Okay, in the liquid state, okay, it undergoes self ionization, like we have water, it also undergoes self ionization. It converts into NO plus, and we have nitrate ion. Okay, this is nitronium ion. Okay, and this is nitrate ion. Okay, since it has positive charge acting as Lewis acid, since it has negative charge, it is acting as Lewis base, ionic equilibrium. Okay, very interesting information. Now see how we are going to complete the reaction. Let's say if I have zinc chloride, okay, when it is reacting with N2O4, okay, it converts into NO plus, and we have NO3 minus. Okay, it will convert into Zn2 plus, and then 2Cl minus is there. Positive negative attraction will be there. This will go this way, and this will go this way. Okay, reaction is complete. Zinc nitrate is there. Zinc nitrate. Okay, and then we have NO plus will combine with Cl, NOCl. This is nitrosyl chloride. Very simple reaction is there. We can balance. We can take a. How you got nitrate exactly? Okay, nitrate is there. We are getting nitrate from here. Okay, so we need two molecules multiplied by two. Okay, then I multiplied by two. Okay, equation is balanced. Now let's move on to the next chemical reaction. The next reaction is with a strong base, NaOH, nitrogen dioxide reacting with a strong base, undergoes a disproportionate redox reaction producing NaNO2, NaNO3 and water molecule. We can balance this equation. 2 sodium multiplied by 2, 2 nitrogen multiplied by 2. Okay, it is present in plus 4 oxidation state, 2 to the 4 plus 3 oxidation state, 3 to the 6 plus 5 oxidation state. This is reduction and this is oxidation. Okay, in the presence of a strong base, it undergoes a disproportionate redox reaction. Okay, next reaction. Nitrogen dioxide dissolves in water molecule, in waters, okay, in the absence of air, when air is not there, in the absence of air, it produces HNO3 and nitrous acid, okay, nitric acid and nitrous acid. Okay, you can balance it. 2 nitrogen are there, balanced. Okay, now pay attention very carefully. Since it is producing in the presence of water, nitric acid as well as nitrous acid, that's why NO2 is known as anhydride of nitric acid and nitrous acid. If I remove water molecule from these two acids, you will get nitrogen dioxide. That's why it is known as anhydride of these two acids. Okay, in case if I dissolve nitrogen dioxide in water in the presence of oxygen, we get only nitric acid. So keep in mind how we are dissolving nitrogen dioxide in waters, in the presence of air or in the absence of air.